Welcome back to Satisfactory. Okay, I was inspired by another video. I'll try to put it in the description. And I think we can make a slight change that will make it a tad better. I'm going to go for, let's see, so it's 4 meters at the bottom. And then let's go 11 meters up. So that'll be 15 total. That's our theoretical center point. Then we'll just give ourselves a little local height boost here. Now, did I say 11? And I already have a toolbar set up just for the objects that we need. Okay, we've got that in straight mode. So now we're just gonna change it to freeform. And then wherever we choose, we need to make sure we choose that same location every time. And then go where the bar is halfway on, halfway off. Then you put a pillar on that. Delete that. Then you put another sign on that pillar. And that's it. The question at this point is only, can you maintain the mental discipline to do this correctly? Probably 90 times. I'm not exactly sure what angle we're hitting here. Just keep repeating this until we've got the full. I think it makes sense just to do. I'm not sure exactly how much of this we should go for. Probably should keep it going though. I think if we're gonna mess it up, it probably makes most sense to mess it up at the bottom. Just keeping it. Finding that rhythm is really the key to this type of building. But we're making sure that we're not starting it from this point. We're starting from this point every time. And we're going halfway on, halfway off. We created that deconstruction because we've got the digital depot. We're pulling from the digital depot, but deconstructing back into our inventory. I'm trying to decide if I should mirror image this thing or not. It's the transport circle, right? And I think we'll start, cancel. We'll start with a support. Not to give it away. Of course, you already know what's going to happen because you get the advantage of seeing the thumbnail. I don't have that advantage. Let's see if we can build this again. I mean, if that's the center, that's the center, right? That's thousands of hours playing this game allows you to make those types of jumps and stand on a less than 1 meter by 1 meter architecture pole. First try with tens of people watching. Let's see here. And then we'll go with the backgrounds. None. Select. Bright, bright, glossy. Uh-huh, there's one under there that I somehow selected instead. We'll do the same thing again. That's letting me know that there's an overlap there that I don't think I want to try to resolve. I could hover. I refuse to cheat and use flying, though it is an option if you so choose it. No judgment on my part towards you, just not what I want to do. Well, that part looks really cool. Do I want to try to save just half? Is there something to be had here? We'll save a fork of it just in case. So I think if you try to build half of this and then copy it in like I did, you run the risk of it not working out. But it worked for me for a reason I can't think through. So let me just finish this thing. Uh-oh. I'm suddenly worried about the bottom half of this. Oh. Shoo. Okay, we might be okay. We'll just have to build it out and see what happens. We could almost build a clock like this. If only we had something that could move. Just trying to stay in the rhythm here. Thank you. Yeah, see, it's coming in under. But I think it's okay because we're gonna put something here anyway that covers this. So this is perfectly fine. Oh, and we're digging into the bottom here anyway. So I'm basically saying put a 4-meter foundation on here. And let it run into it like that. You know what I mean? Oh, that's looking good. I mean, I might have to find a use for this, just like generally. This is looking so amazing. Maybe that's the entrance to this mega factory. Let's stay on rhythm here. Gotta make sure we go back and get these two. That was a miss. Almost there. I normally build horizontal circles. This is my first vertical circle. Same exact principle applies. I don't know why I didn't think about trying this earlier. one minor imperfection right there. Oh, that's gonna bother me. I might have to delete all of this to fix this. We made the mistake of thinking we could fix that after the fact. I'm already thinking of places to put this thing. I'm excited by this. This is gonna be very cool. One or two more. Yeah, no matter what, this particular method of building circles is... Well, that's not true, though. Well, building it in a blueprint offers this problem. But we're just gonna accept... that this is working. That's just what we're gonna do. We're just gonna say it's working. And we're gonna do that by covering the center with the object of something like that. Pretty cool. And then right here we could put something like, I mean, we put whatever we want at this point. You could put a hypertube support. Or two, you could put train tracks, though I don't have train tracks researched yet. You might be able to get a door to look kind of nice in here. With some tweaking, you could really probably make this work as a center. Like if I nudge this way, you wouldn't even see. Well, there's a little corner there. Maybe if I nudged it twice. I don't know how high that would work. How high up you could go with this. Nudgery. Yeah, because then you gotta nudge it back to justify this side. Well, it might work. There's some real potential here. There's a tiny space. I might have to go with shorter wall, then nudge it this way. Then we'll just rebuild it. That covers that whole area. Oh boy, I'm kind of liking this a lot. I don't know what you're going to do to get this to connect to the other part of the wall. Or if you could even do it. But as an entrance, there might be something there. Let's call this the circle entrance. And we'll put the door icon on it just to be clear what we're trying to do. And then I think I'm just going to leave this with the inverted ramp. I think, or maybe just the hyper tubes. Do I want the support or do I want this guy? I don't know. Either way, what do you think? Are we doing something here? I think we're doing something. Let's do a little test. Uh-oh. We need reinforced plate. Apparently we need a lot of reinforced plate. Whoops. I didn't exactly hit that in the right spot. There's definitely something there. Maybe we need to tweak this a little bit more, but I definitely like the basic idea, the full circle and the imperfection hidden inside the bottom there. I think that's the innovation. But you'll let me know what you think. Is that something? Have we done something cool? Should I make use of this circle in other places? Is the entrance, does that have some possibility? Should I just drop a cool tower circle over here to be part of the reflection pool? This is just basically turning into a monument. We could do something cool in the center of this. Whatever that measurement may be. It's 8. 8 is not a good centering for thing that is I guess it could be 8 on the middle. So we take it off the grid. If I put a hypertube entrance in here, it could be a fun little observation area. Totally winging it, by the way. I think we should be able to get this to go. Except we lack the basic reinforced plate. Let's get this on our to-do list. I could have deleted these test ones. But let's see if we've got the quartz crystal we need in the blueprint storage. Oh yeah, plenty. Just need to get it so we could nudge it. Does it work better without the inverted ramps? Probably. It definitely needs a little something. As far as, like, is it a thing? Is it something that we want to keep doing? Is it worth the effort? I think so. And now that we've got it in a blueprint, we can definitely make use of it in other ways. Technically, I should probably make this a half foundation all the way around. We don't have access to the half foundations, but we do have access to the nudge. What happens if I pop up out of here? Let's leave that for later because I'm not 100% sure this is the right height. We might want to increase the height of this thing. But from a design standpoint, I definitely like it. It's definitely working. You'll let me know what you think. And we will see you next time. Thanks for hanging out. I do appreciate it. I don't even know what I'm going to call this thing. I don't even know how to get a good shot. Yeah, I know the video's still going. We'll see you next time.